So, hi everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever the time is. So, this is Dimple and we are back with the Spec Flow sessions. So, today is the first session which I am going to conduct for the Spec Flow. So, in the first session, you are going to learn what is the spec flow, what are the feature files, what are the scenarios, what is a gherkin, what is given when then. So next we will start with the practical. So the first is about the theoretical session. So we'll just learn about the spec flow more, not the practical. So for that you need the Visual Studio install, then you need to go extensions and updates. In that you will be able to see the spec flow for Visual Studio, which is already installed. So you have to install it first of all. So we'll see later on what we have to do. So basically, spec flow is a BDD framework. Why we are using spec flow nowadays more and not the test driven development? So the main difference is that the test driven development basically says that it is a test driven development. So we have to write down the code which we are going to test. The test cases were basically written in the method format and we are not able to give them to the business or the BA as they were not able to understand what we have automated in the TDD. So for them, the BDD frameworks came, and BDD is basically for the people who are not from the coding background, so they can easily understand the automation cases. As well as it's easy to write and easy to read by anyone that what are the business requirement. So that's why the spec flow is. So basically, spec flow is just a tool where we are writing the acceptance test cases also. At certain levels, we will be writing the regression test cases also. At certain level, we are writing the smoke test case also. So it depends on the automation suite which you are going to create. So let's start with the spec flow structure. So basically the spec flow contains feature file. So basically what is the feature file? Feature file, let's give an example to that. In a website, we have a login functionality. We have a shopping functionality, we have a payment functionality. So all that are one kind of features. You can shop different types of mobiles, televisions, home appliances. So that is also one kind of functionality. So if I need to check whether I can purchase the home appliances on XYZ website with cash on delivery, so this is one kind of functionality. So that scenario is going to be added in the feature file. Now what kind of feature it will be? The login one, the home appliances, or the payment one? So we can say this feature is basically for the home appliances. So we'll add that scenario in this feature file. So you can have a simple example, take it the login functionality. We can have a negative as well as positive scenarios of login. So all that are scenarios which are related to one of the functionality that will be part of the feature file. So let's come now, what is the scenario? So scenario is nothing but the thing which the system is behaving, the steps which we are performing to achieve some functionality. Suppose you have to do the login. So what is the steps? You have to write the username, you have to write the password, and you are going to click on the button. So that is one scenario. So scenario contains what? Steps. So as you have seen that I have written, or I have asked you to say three steps for the login scenario. So scenario can be multiples in the feature file, and the same scenarios might be having more than one of the steps, and the same steps are repeated in multiple scenarios also. So there can be multiple feature files, there can be multiple scenarios too, and the scenarios contain the steps. Now what does these steps do? Now how the computer will know that you have to type the username, you have to type the password, and you have to click on the login button. So for there we are writing what? Test code. That will be basically your Selenium part. So now who is going to handle these all things? That is a testing framework. So here comes NUnit. You might be using XUnit. So it depends up to you, whatever you are using. We have other options also. So this is up to you. So basically I have had created one unit test project further to see how this scenario steps file will be. But before that, we will see the basic structure of feature file scenarios, and that's all. So let's start. I have created a unit project and I have added the references of spec flow as well as NUnit framework so that I can see the features in the test explorer. So I have created the two folders, features and step file. You can delete the CS file which was created with the unit test project. We don't need that. So we'll create a new feature. Create a new item. So you can see if we haven't installed this spec flow, it will not come here. If you haven't installed, please install it. We'll create a feature file, add it. So you can see here, this is the feature keyword and the feature file name and the feature description is displayed here. Same way, here is the scenario. I said that feature file contains the multiple scenarios. So here it is a scenario, scenario description that you are adding the two numbers, and we have these steps that I have entered 50, then we enter 70, then I press add, then I got 120 on the screen. So that is the basic calculation for the addition functionality. So these are the gherkins which we have created, and these are called the scenario. Now we will see how to create the step file for that. So just right click on any of the step, generate the step definition. So you don't need to worry, you don't have to create it. So in this we have different types of styles, so we will see that later on. So for just now, we will just copy the methods to clipboard. I have created one folder for step file, so we'll just create a step definition, spec flow file, and we'll remove all the things from the class, and we'll paste. So as you can see, I have copied the steps definition from the clipboard and I have pasted it. So I have got all the things that are written in the scenarios. So you can see the color is changed from the purple to black. It means the step definition has got match. Now if I click here and press F12, so it will go to the definition file. But if it is not going, then you have to build it. If it is not still going, it might be building in the background, so it will take some time. So now you can see my scenario is coming in the test explorer. This is coming from the test menu window and open the test explorer. So you can see here all the test cases, all the scenarios, whichever you have written in this section. So you can just right click here and run it. So you can see the result, whether it is pass or whether it is fail, it will be displayed here. Now it is getting fail. It is saying that one or more step definitions are not implemented yet. But what happened? Look at it. We have implemented it, but the scenario is pending. We have to remove these, otherwise it will say. So we now run it. So you can see now it got pass, right? So this is the basic example of the spec flow. Now the next we will explain what is given, when, then, how to write the basic test cases and how to maintain the spec flows. And I will be giving some tips and tricks on the spec flow. Meanwhile, also, if you like the video, please like it, please share it, and please don't forget to subscribe. Bye, sayonara.